And away we go. It is the nightcap right here on BearcatJournal.com, brought to you, as always, by our good friends at Galactic Fried Chicken. Visit www.galacticfriedchicken.com. Download the app for Android, iPhone, everything Galactic, and get down to Dayton, Kentucky, Wednesday through Sunday, lunch and dinner. Tell them to pump it up. Save yourself 15% off of your order. Or go to the app. Have it delivered. They'll bring it to you pretty much anywhere inside the 275 loop, and you can get your Galactic fix. All right, Aaron. We're gonna take a little bit of a break tonight. It has been wall-to-wall coaching content. And if the coaching search is your thing, right now, right before we hit record, I just published Hot Board version 2.0. And guess what, Aaron? The folks at 24/7 forgot to turn the sale off. It is still, until they turn it off, whenever that may be, so I would act fast, it is still 75% off a full year of Bearcat Journal. So get to BearcatJournal.com, click join, and what are you laughing at?
Just, you posted this, what, like
10 minutes when, ago, and it's 63 comments.
74 comments, almost 3,000 views.
Yeah, I just posted.
What are we doing?
While you're here, also like and subscribe. I know there's a lot of you here. We'll get back to
232,000 plus on the original Hot Board. Yeah. What are we doing?
F5. People are getting carpal tunnel from hitting F5. We love you guys. We absolutely love you guys. That thing was only up for 48 hours.
you posted this 17 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Good God.
So, basketball media today. How about that?
Talking about talking.
Basketball team is back in action tomorrow night. They play the New Jersey Institute of Technology, featuring Paul McMillan, who I believe is shooting 29% or 21% from the field this year, and 11% from three in his five games for Victor Lockett.
Well,
we have to talk about Vic first. We have to.
Yes, fine. That he was ready with props.
I don't know the video that UC put out. Did it have the initial interaction?
He said, "Oh, you want to talk about Maui?"
Yeah, yeah. And he pulled out his sunglasses, mm-hmm. and he pulled out his red and black lei, mm-hmm. and he pulled out his Bearcat Tiki bucket hat, which if they don't sell that Bearcat Tiki stuff, What are we doing?
It's a miss.
That's amazing. Mm-hmm. It's amazing.
It should be
one of the best Bearcat logos I've ever seen.
I have a Bearcat Hawaiian shirt, actually, and that was a miss on my part for not wearing it last week when we were doing a show at some point in time.
Yeah.
I think mom picked it up at Costco for like $20 or something.
Yeah.
But there's no reason why there shouldn't be several versions of Hawaiian shirts with like that logo as the like everywhere all over it.
Yeah.
One with just the Hawaiian flowers and then that logo on the chest. Like, yeah, there's a lot you could do with that. It's a great logo, but yeah, Vic stole the show. And as a Russian, never envisioned himself going to Hawaii to play basketball. On the flip side, you had Landers Nolly, who's now been to Maui twice to play
basketball. Might as well be the king of Hawaii.
Said he loved the rims out there. They're awful kind to him.
You can watch a game at the Maui Invitational, and those are literally the softest rims in the world.
The commentators at one point did mention about how soft the rims are there.
Oh, softest rims in the world.
Which I guess makes up for the fact that you have 748 lines on the court, but
it is.
Plus the obnoxious logo in the key.
You hate everything.
I don't hate everything. There was just a lot happening on that court. Like, you're hosting a giant basketball tournament. Just get flooring for that tournament without the volleyball court.
You're on edge.
Yeah, there's been a lot going on this week. I'm not sleeping a ton. There is a baby.
You're on edge. You need a couple days off?
No. But I'm
good because I wasn't going to give them to you.
I may be at the anger stage of the breakup at this point. So, who knows?
Oh, boy. But yeah, what anything else from Vic other than just his personality as like if this, and I think this is the Victor Lockin we're going to get now. He's coming out of his shell. He's becoming comfortable. Like if this is the Vic we're going to get for the rest of his career at UC, I'm 1,000% in.
There was definitely some other stuff I got. I thought that was the most insightful Vic's been.
He's a really smart kid.
He is. And I got to learn a little bit more about David DeJulius as a leader. Apparently DeJulius doesn't even realize some of the things that he does as a leader, and Vic's taking notice and taking notes and trying to emulate what Dave does both on and off the court, which I just found that very interesting as we kind of hinted around, maybe Dave isn't such a vocal leader. And while that still may be true, without saying anything, he continues to be a leader for this team, especially for young guys like Vic. So I think that was just a nice little nugget that I got. Also, Vic is very in tune with what he needs to do to be better. He mentioned himself without even being asked about the foul trouble, about the free throws. He knows what he needs to work on. Even while Coach was talking, Wes did allude to the fact that he would love to get Vic out there more, but they're trying to find that balance between how much they can put him out there and him being at his highest level of performance out there. Found it interesting that last season he did not work out nearly as much in season as he is now and trying to get better and bigger. I think he used it in that order as opposed to bigger and better. So obviously there's an emphasis in his eyes at continuing to get bigger in every way to continue to help this team. So I don't know. I thought that was an awful lot of information to get out of not a ton of time with Vic up there at the podium. And, just again, very insightful of Vic up there.
And he's fun. Like be interesting, be fun. Like, have some personality. That's what fans want. That's what they want to see.
Yeah.
Wes Miller, I thought, was pretty insightful today. Wes doesn't give you a lot of coach speak. Like, he will at times. But he talks about.
I disagree. I thought he gave a ton of coach speak, but
I think he talked about trying to figure out their identity, what he wants their identity to be.
He did.
And the limitations on getting there. What you have to do if your team maybe doesn't have the players to have your identity. Like, there's always coaches are going to use.
I get that.
Coach speak. But if you ask the right questions and you drill down a little bit, like, you can get them to talk about a lot of the things that people have been talking about on the board. What is this team's identity? What do you want this team's identity to be? Have you found it yet? He has answered all of those questions.
Sure, and he hasn't, and he admitted as much. I think when he smiles, I forget that he's even giving coach speak, and I'm just like, oh.
He's so cute.
But no, I mean, it's. I think he gives a ton of coach speak in general. But today, I will agree. I think he gave a little bit more of a peek behind the curtain than he tends to do. He did mention the fact that it's been a little bit frustrating for him that they haven't been able to, as we've talked about here, practice in between some of those games, not just in Maui, but the amount of practice time in between some of these early games to try and fix things. They haven't had that opportunity to get to the lab and try and work on what this team can do to overcome some of their shortcomings when you have a Newman out, when you don't have a ton of depth at the big and you're quickly realizing that that's becoming an issue in every game.
Let's see.
I don't know that Nolly gave us a ton outside of just laughing about Maui.
I don't think he got a lot of great questions, if we're being honest. Maybe that's on me. You got a game tomorrow, then December 4th. So you've got Thursday, Friday, Saturday there. You got some practice time. Then finals week, Xavier on the 10th, Miami on the 14th, LaSalle on the 17th. So that's a pretty normal week. Then Detroit Mercy on the 21st, then a week off. You know, they'll get a little bit of a Christmas break. But, you know, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 games. The next 7 games are at home. The Crosstown Shootout is one of them, obviously. But then the last one is conference play with Tulane coming to town. December 29th, sorry. So there is in December a little bit more time to get on the court. It's a little bit more normal. You're not having any of those weeks where you're playing like Monday, Thursday, Saturday. It's more like a game during the week, a game on the weekend, a game during the week, a game on the weekend. So you get a little bit more into that rhythm of the season.
Sure.
So I think you should have a chance to get some more practice time. Practice was open today. I think I saw about 4 minutes of practice. I get stuck gathering info for a while on a couple different things, which is why we got a hot board version 2.0 tonight. And then I had to do Mo's show. By the time I got to practice, I was there for like 4 minutes, and then Taryn called and I had to step outside and do Mo's show. And then I came back and I watched about another 4 minutes, and then I got another call from a source. I had to step back outside. And when I came back in, they were done. I was like, well, shit. This coaching search stuff is a real pain in the ass.
The beat doesn't die.
No, it's a lot of, like, I'm so glad, Aaron, that we're not, remember those days when you had to pay for your phone, like, by the minute, like, your minute plan?
Yeah.
I'm glad we don't do that anymore.
Remember when you had to pay per text?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Man. I used to sell phones. So did you.
Yeah, like, same.
I remember those days.
Yeah.
Very well. So, yeah, you got anything else on talking about talking?
No, I mean, obviously you didn't have anything from football, even though people were freaking out on the interwebs about the ESPN Plus having a football presser link available.
That was just, they forgot to take it.
It was a filler. Yeah, it was a filler for what they normally have scheduled. For
Luke Fickell's weekly press conference.
Yep. Yep.
And I even had a couple parents text me, like, what's football player parents, are you at this press conference? And I was like, I'm gonna get in the shower and go to basketball. But if there's a press conference right now, you know who they have not alerted? The press. Has not been alerted. And then I called somebody on campus and was like, hey, this is on ESPN. They were like, rattle, rattle, rattle. And then it got taken care of. So those are everybody's, I mean, I get it. Everybody's on edge. Everybody is very, very, very on edge. There's 150 posts in that thread now. It's been up for 29 minutes. So
that's crazy.
And if you're new and you're just getting into all this, here's another. I can promise you this: a lot of sites will update the hot board or, you know, whatever with any tiny little piece of information. If I'm updating the hot board, there have been changes or there have been a lot of new pieces of information that have gotten out to where I put out a new version. I don't clickbait you. I would get yelled at, and I'm sure T-Win will yell at me for this at some point in time. I do not clickbait our members. I probably should. You guys would click on it, whatever I put up, but I trust the relationship and the bond that Bearcat Journal as a staff has with our community. If I put something up, it's going to be worth putting up. It's not just going to be, you know, Gino interviewed at 8:30 this morning. New hot board, and everything stays the same except for the one line that Gino had an interview with John Cunningham at 8:30 this morning. It's not how we do it. There's three new head coach, sitting head coach names. There's one new coordinator name. So there's a bunch of new stuff in there. So get to BearcatJournal.com, and until corporate figures out that they haven't turned this sale off, you can get it. I don't have an answer for when it's going to turn off, but
75% off, $25 gets you unfiltered access to all the hot boards, to everything, all of it.
And the boards have been what I would call active.
Yeah, 5,500 views already.
The boards have been what I would call active.
20 minutes, 5,500 views. You guys are crazy. You're so animals.
Jump in. Become a member. Join the community. We have fun like this all year. That's about what I got. PTP tonight. We'll see you for the BCJ podcast on Thursday at 7. It's going to be a Thursday 7 p.m. show. Rock of Truth at 9.
Aaron, guest on Thursday.
Oh.
West Side Jesus.
Oh. Current head coach. Current head coach of your Cincinnati Bearcats. Let's go.
We'll see you next time. It's the Nightcap, brought to you by Galactic Fried Chicken, right here on BearcatJournal.com.
See ya!